This week on Coyote Country, good friends Kale and Marquis Bromley invited us to their country oasis on a late warm October day near Smoky Lake, Alberta, where they raise ring-necked pheasants all summer long with the plans of releasing these unique and colorful looking birds into the river valley on their home quarter. Oh, and let's not forget the real workhorses of this adventure, as both Boone and Lock worked hard in flushing and retrieving these beautiful long-tailed birds. Now you heard that rooster, let's get to that Ring Neck Valley action. Hi there and welcome to Coyote Country. This week we're going to share with you some late October wing shooting as we head out to the farm of good friends Kale and Marquis Bromley for some pheasant hunting.
That's right. And also joining us on this day-long adventure is Kale's father Dan, his cousin John, and John's girlfriend Justine.
Now I have to admit I was skeptical in filming this style of hunt, but I think at the end of the day when we came back home with literally hours of footage and the fact that we couldn't wait to get in on the action next year, I think that speaks to mission accomplished.
I couldn't agree with you more. Seeing those dogs working and all of the farm animals sure brought back some fond memories of my childhood.
But enough said, let's get to that Ring Neck Valley action.
So what do you got happening here, Kale?
We've got some pheasants we're gonna put out and do a little bit of hunting. We bought a bunch this spring, put up a new pen and been raising them all summer, I guess. And it's October 24th, I think.
It is.
And I think we've got about 44, 45 roosters, ringneck pheasant, and I think we've got about 38 Hungarian partridge. So we're gonna go place a bunch of birds, come back, have a nice little coffee, and bite to eat perhaps, and then make war on some upland game birds, a little wing shooting on a Saturday morning.
Nothing better.
Nothing better.
Okay, boys.
Four so far. We got a few more coming.
Okay.
We've got our pheasants in the kennels. I think, what do we got? About 30 birds?
Yeah, about 30 birds.
30 birds, a mix of some hens and roosters, mostly roosters. We're gonna be letting the hens go today, hoping they reproduce. We've got some land down by the river here. We're gonna let them all out and place some of these birds and come back after a coffee, give them a chance, and have at it. So,
yeah.
What do you figure?
It'll be good.
You betcha.
Lots of cover.
We'll get this thing started up. We'll get down there.
Good. Right on. Here we are at the first set. We're gonna put out a few birds here and then work our way.
Pull this out all the way, I think, guys. Hey?
Yeah.
We'll try and do this without stressing them out too much.
I'll put my hand up here.
So what we'll do is we'll tuck the pheasant's head under its wing, and then we'll flip them upside down. And what this does is it calms the bird, actually puts them to sleep, and they should stay in this position in this spot here for an hour or two after. And then we'll come back after we've gone up and had coffees and stuff with the dogs and see if our dogs do the job. So we'll open this up a bit so that there's kind of a bit of a hole in the grass. And then we bring it down over top of them, and then they settle in there. There we go. There we go.
Hi, my name is Justine, and this is Marquis, and we are down here at the River Valley, and we're gonna release some hens.
Ready? One, two, three.
We'll just give them some time to...
We'll have a coffee?
Yeah, we'll have a coffee.
We'll have a coffee.
And we'll tell some stories. And...
Sure.
Yeah.
Sounds good.
Okay.
Okay,
team.
High
to the lodge.
Lunch.
To the lodge.
Well, we're going to shoot a few clays, get warmed up, I think. Hey, girls?
Yeah, right.
What do you think? Get used to the firearms we're using. We've got a little bit of everything today. Some side-by-side, some over and unders, some stuff from 1895, I think.
Yeah, pretty old stuff.
Some real vintage equipment, and we'll get safe here. Safety first. Bust some clays.
Sounds good.
Get ready.
Betcha.
Hey.
Winner.
Oh.
There you are.
So we've got our next bird dog coming down the lane. He likes to make a late entrance. Mr. Howard von Bakenvich.
We got the retriever.
Oh, we got our safety
pig.
There's our safety pig. Well, we're warmed up. We've busted a bunch of clays. We went through, I think, a box of clays and a bunch of shells, and we got all the firearms ready to go. The dogs are anxious. The sun's out. Birds are ready. What do you say, guys? Girls?
Yeah, let's go get some pheasants.
They've had some time. We've given them the head start that they get, and now it's on.
It's all about the dogs now.
That's yeah.
Right.
Watch them perform.
Right on.
Right on, guys.
Let's go do it, guys.
Let's
get them.
Lock, boy. Heel. Sit. Sit. Here, finish. Okay, so I think we'll make sure we're walking in a single file line, you guys, and we'll put three on one side of the bush. Looks like we saw a rooster on the one side, so we'll put the girls over there with Dad maybe, and John and I will take the left side.
Okay, sure.
That way we have a dog on either side, and just important to make sure we're always in a single file, not single file, so we're just in a straight line across from each other.
Yep. And if you don't feel 100%, don't pull the trigger.
That's right. That's watch right. The dogs, watch your shot, check your gun.
Good boy, fine bird. Here, boy. Boone, come. Come. Here. Finish. Right. Finish. Sit. Hold.
Enough.
There he is. I see him.
Yeah,
he's gonna go.
Here comes, guys.
Here
it
is.
Guys, thank you.
Well,
I didn't shoot any.
I got two fresh ones.
I got two fresh ones, too.
So in total they would have, there's two machine guns and a double, so that's six and two is eight.
Eight shells.
One rooster.
One rooster,
That's an expensive rooster.
Holy moly.
That's an expensive rooster.
We're going to talk about that at lunch.
Oh, yeah.
Holy cow.
Talk about lack of TSN turning point.
Holy.
Would you like an explanation about that?
Dang it.
That is the luckiest pheasant in Smoky Lake County right now.
Stay tuned for more action on Coyote Country.
Join Coyote Country on Facebook for live updates or check us out at coyotecountry.ca.
Dog's on.
Yep. Rooster! Shot.
Good. Come on. Attaboy, Boone. Sit. Sit. Sit.
Good boy. Good boy.
Hold him. Hold him. Thank you. Oh.
Good boy.
Good shooting, guys.
Yeah, we got one more poach.
Beautiful. Beautiful birds. Very nice shot.
Dogs are working well. Hey, buddy. That's what they live for.
That's what they live for.
Good boy. Can you finish? Attaboy. Attaboy. Okay. Hand him up.
The girls,
yeah,
and Uncle Dan is the backer. Why don't you guys walk straight through there?
Yeah.
him.
Good shot.
Right here, Boondog. Come, finish. Boon, finish.
Well, we're gonna take a break. I think the dogs are spent. Have a little bit of lunch. It's close to noon anyways. We've got a few birds. We donated a lot of birds as well and educated a few. So we're all gonna have a little break, get a little bit of food in us and let some more birds go for this afternoon. Try and do it again. Come on, buddy. Yep.
We're gonna look at getting Justine her second pheasant of the year. She struggled a little bit this morning, which is, I'm not going to say surprising.
I think I
everybody gets a turn at a TSN turning
point. Everyone
gets
a turn here.
Yeah. So. Everyone gets their chance at the TSN turning point.
So yeah, we're going to we're all mounted up, ready to go. The dogs are watered.
Yep.
They're in good shape, performed really well, so hopefully we get another real good crack at them here this afternoon.
Yep.
There you have it. Well, yeah, Justine's got a gun too this time.
Yeah. Got my machine gun.
Yep.
Okay.
Going down.
Let's get at it, you guys.
Come on, Boondog.
Yep.
Heads up, guys. Here's our guys running towards you.
Whoa.
You're Marie.
Thanks, Dan.
Beautiful rooster.
You can stick it to do whatever you want it to.
We had to get a bird.
Well, when you have to actually retrieve one, it takes some time. You guys can just keep going. It doesn't take any time.
Show the viewers what you're using.
Just to look at the little one. Just a little skinny 410. A lot smaller than the big 12 gauge shells over there that the young guys are using.
And it got her done.
Yeah. When you get older, you get a little wiser and a little sharper and you only need the little shells.
Yeah. You might want to speak up so they hear that.
Kinsey
had a little quiet, didn't he? That's okay. Nice retrieve, guys.
Right on.
We had a great day. It's late October. We couldn't get better weather for what we did today. Dogs work well. We got some birds, left some for seed. Had a great time. We got quite a few birds here. Everybody's, I think, a little bit tired, ready for some supper.
And good shooting, everybody. Back in the day, we'd like to thank Coyote Country for the opportunity and coming out with us. Took some great shots, and I think we've got some great action footage. Hope everybody that gets to watch us enjoys what we did today and gets to enjoy a little bit of wing shooting out in the field as much as we do as well.
About as good as it gets this late in October. Pheasant hunting, Alberta. She's a beauty.
Thanks, Coyote Country.
Woo
woo! Woo! Yeah.
Thanks, Coyote Country.
And that's a wrap.
That's a wrap for this year.
Now, being that the both of us had never hunted pheasants before, and after watching all that footage, I can't tell you enough that we can hardly wait for this coming fall.
Yeah, that's for sure. It was really great watching the trained dogs in action, and especially the camaraderie of this group. You can really tell they love wing shooting.
Well, that wraps it up for another week, and we hope to see you next week right here on Coyote Country.
Coyote Country was proudly presented by CR Backwoods. Join Coyote Country team member Leo and his father Robert as they add some fuel to their coyote obsessions on next week's episode titled Alberta Coyotes.